Hello and welcome to Answering ATPL. In today's video, we will discuss on the subject of general navigation under topic basic of navigation, subtopic the earth, great circle track. Question was taken from Aviation Exam database, question number 66068. An aircraft passes position A, 60 degree north, 120 degree west, en route to position B, 60 degree north, 140 degree, 30 minute west. What is the great circle track on departure from E? In this video, I will only explain the method of answering this question. For the theory, check out the video displayed on the screen. Link is also available in the description. There are two methods of answering this question. Before answering the question, we first need to extract the data given by the question. Given, position A, located at 60 degree north, 120 degree west, and position B, located at 60 degree north, 140 degree, 30 minute west, which is equal to 140.5 degree west. Why 0.5 degree? This is because 1 degree equal to 60 minutes. Thus, 30 minutes equal to 30 divided by 60 equal to 0.5 degree. Find the great circle track at A. For the first method, we need to draw a diagram. First, draw the meridian, or also known as longitude. As you can see, both meridians are converging toward North Pole. Why it is converging toward North Pole? If we look at this picture, we can see that all meridian in the Northern Hemisphere is converging toward North Pole. And all meridian in Southern Hemisphere are converging toward South Pole. Thus, the convention of drawing meridian are converging toward closer pole. Next, we need to draw the given latitude. Latitude is drawn as curved line concave to the nearer pole. For this question, it is North Pole. Our latitude is green in color. After that, we need to draw our track, which is a great circle track, and it is represented by a straight line because great circle is the shortest track between two points on the surface of the earth. Our track is yellow in color. Next, we need to determine which meridian line that we had drawn represent 120 degree west and which one represent 140.5 degree west. If this line represent prime meridian or 0 degree longitude, to its right will be east and to its left will be west. Counting up from 0, 10, 20, 30 and so on, 120 degree west should be here and 140.5 degree west should be here. Now we know that this line represents 120 degree west and this line represents 140.5 degree west. As we know, if we fly following the latitude, we will fly a Rhumb line track. Since we were given only one latitude and traveling west, the Rhumb line track will be 270 degree. 270 are measured from here to here. We want to find great circle track at position A. We need to add this angle. This is because great circle track is measured from here to here. This angle is known as conversion angle. The formula for conversion angle: conversion angle equal to half convergency. Since no chart or type of chart is mentioned in the question, we will use Earth convergency. Convergency is equal to change of longitude time sine mean latitude. 140.5 minus 120 time sine mean latitude. Sine mean latitude is the average of the latitude between two points. Thus, mean latitude is 60 plus 60 divided by 2 equal to 60. Convergence equal to 140.5 minus 120 times sine 60 equal to 17.7 degree. If we round it up, approximately 18 degree. Thus, conversion angle equal to 9 degree. Angle here is 9 degree. To find the answer, we need to add 270 with 9 degree. The answer will be true track at A equal to 270 plus 9 equal to 279. For the second method, we will use the DIID diagram. We need to determine at which quadrant position A and B is located. First, we look at the latitude. Since the latitude is 60 degrees north, we are in the northern hemisphere. Northern hemisphere is this side. Next, we need to determine where A and B is located in relation to the DIID diagram. To do this, we need to determine between these two longitudes which one is on the right and which one is on the left. We assume that this line is prime meridian or 0 degree longitude. To the right is east and to the left is west. 120 degree should be here and 140.5 degree should be here. Thus, position A should be here and position B should be here. Position A is located in the I quadrant. I mean increase. Thus, true track at A is equal to Rhumb line track plus conversion angle. For Rhumb line track, if we travel to the west along the same latitude, in this case 60 degree north, we will travel on 270 degree track. For conversion angle, the formula is conversion angle equal to half convergency. Since the question does not mention chart or chart projection, we will use Earth convergence formula. Thus, conversion angle equal to half time change of longitude time sine mean latitude equal to half time 140.5 minus 120 times sine 60. Mean latitude, mean average of two latitude, equal to half times 140.5 minus 120 times sine 60 equal to 8.88 degree. If we round it up, conversion angle is 9 degree. Thus, true track at A is equal to 270 plus 9 equal to 279 degree. Looking back at the question, the answer is D. That will be all for this video. Thank you for watching and have a very nice day. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe and check out other videos.